Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Gino and today's video is going to be a year in review. Now, a lot has happened in the last year and naturally I would take photos and videos. So this is what today's video is going to be. It's a compilation of everything luxury related that has happened to me in the last year. If I was a YouTuber back in 2022, I would have filmed a lot more content. In fact, there were a lot of things that happened in the luxury world back in 2022 that I wish that I had documented more thoroughly because I would have actually made a lot more videos back then. So unfortunately, I don't really have a lot of clips to show pre-2023, but I'll share what I have anyway. Before we continue, this is just for display. The only reason to go shopping at Dior during Christmas is just for the packaging. And today's candle that I have lit is the Baize candle, which is blackcurrant and roses. As a side note, the carousel on this one spins a lot faster than this one. And I would have filmed a year in review video at the end of 2022 if I had known that I would be a more dedicated YouTuber, but better late than never. So what's going to happen is that I'm going to go through my camera roll and my Instagram archive simultaneously and just react to the photos and clips that I come across. And this is going to be strictly luxury related. So no cat videos, no dog videos. And to make up for lost time, I'm going to include October to December of 2022 in this video. So today is December 2nd, so I'm going to be covering 14 months worth of content.
You strap yourself in and feel the G's!
Oh lord!
15 October 2022, there was the Hermes Fit interactive exhibit that was on at the Holden Pavilion. So of course I went and I took a whole bunch of photos and clips. Hermes fruit display. And it was an interactive exhibit, so you could punch the punching bags, you could lift the weights, but you couldn't touch the leather goods or the shoes on display, which is kind of counterintuitive because this is an interactive exhibit, but there were security guards telling you that you can't touch some of the stuff. So what's the point of having it on display if you can't touch it? 20 October. This is the day that I picked up my LED puzzle. I've already done a whole video about it, so I won't go through it here again. One of the essays actually took a clip of me reacting to receiving the puzzle for the first time, and some other shots of the bag in the store. On the 22nd of October, I went to the Star Casino and did a photo shoot with the bag. I like this clip, 29 October, where I put my puzzle bag on a shelf of all these other black bags. Admittedly, half of those black bags are not mine. I miss that Fendi soft trunk, oh well. On 31 October, I took my Fendi soft trunk on a photo shoot. I forgot the location of this. Paddington Reservoir Gardens, okay. 5 November. This is when the LV exhibit came to Sydney.
Black Dead.
I wore both my LED puzzle and my Speedy. Just before I went to that exhibit, I actually went to LV in Bondi Junction and picked up perfume and a belt for myself. 20 November, I went to this family function event. So I wore my tuxedo and my LED puzzle. And that was the day that I took my iconic thumbnail for this channel. 26 November, the Gucci Garden exhibit. That was a fun day, although very short. It was mostly just a visual spectacle with some bags and some clothes. 2 December, this is a photo of me at the Langham in Sydney, just posing with my book tote. 9 December, another productive day at Loewe. What did I get there? I don't remember. I remember the cookie. But what was that item? God, I don't remember. I went to Newcastle on the 27th of December, and on the drive back after the trip, which was the 28th of December, I get a text from my SA saying that the VIC gift had arrived. And well, I was looking a bit disheveled after that trip, but I was like, I still want to pick up this gift today. I'm really excited. I don't know what it is, but suffice to say that I was very surprised by the size of the box. That gift was a candle, which was the, what's the scent of that candle? The VIC gift was one of their candles and this handmade wreath. Yeah, this wreath is very delicate. The slightest touch and the small leaves fall off. Once I had it hanging up, I never touched it. I even bought a matching room spray, and sometimes I spray that on the wreath, so it acts as a diffuser of sorts. 19 January, I pick up my Loewe Lunar New Year gift, which was a pair of chopsticks with chopstick holders in the shape of rabbits, and this wooden presentation box, and some red envelopes. 21 January, I get a text from my SA at LV. He says that he's got some red envelopes for me, and I'm a very modest shopper at LV. I don't really have a strong profile there. I'm so glad that he actually kept some envelopes for me. I thought that was very kind of him. That's the day I picked up my Yayoi Kusama pouch. And I still love that piece. In fact, I think that's one of my top 5 most favorite purchases ever. Some more red envelopes. 2 February, that's the day that Loewe's Howl's Moving Castle collection officially dropped. So I only picked up a card holder that day, but I got all these extra freebies, including a couple of swing tags and a shopping bag and this book. The book is just full of dotted pages. So it's not really functional for my use, but I still keep it as a collector's piece. So while everyone else was clamoring to get a piece of the Howl's Moving Castle collection, I actually did buy a bag, but not from this collection. It was actually my bum bag. I was planning for 2023 to be where I would pace my purchases. So if I bought a bag, there would be several months gaps in between, just so my bank account could recover. And around the same time, Loewe released previews of their Raffia tote bags. When I saw that, I was like, yes, reserve one for me, please. So I picked that one up on 24 February, but I still got the Howl's Moving Castle shopping bag for that, which was really nice. 25 February, I take that bag out to Bondi Beach and do a photo shoot there. Honestly, one of my favorite videos to film, just because all of those photos, there's no photoshopping, there's no retouching. The colors are genuinely that vibrant in real life as you see it in these photos. So 30 March, Loewe have a ready-to-wear event in store, and with every purchase you get some anthurium flowers. So I picked up two shirts. Oh, that's the fragrance that I bought, juniper berry. So that's the home scent I spray on my wreath, and that's the same scent as the candle. I went to Melbourne for Easter. My LED bag, of course, came with me. I mean, I don't have any footage of this, but I know that people were staring at me when I was walking around the CBD wearing this bag. I'm surprised no one ever actually came up to me and like asked about it. Because I love souvenirs, I decided to pick up some few odds and ends at Gucci, Celine, Fendi, and Loewe. So what did I get? I got two belts, card holder, and the Parade perfume. Yeah. Absolutely love these purchases, except for the card holder. I rarely use that, but whatever. I would have filmed a lot more in Melbourne, but it was actually very wet and raining. The weather was unpredictable and there were so many people in the shopping centers and on the streets. So none of my footage actually looked good. So I kind of just gave up trying to film anything. I just took some photos here and there. There wasn't really much happening. 27 April. I just stopped by the store and they finally started serving Moe to their customers, so I got myself a glass, even though I didn't buy anything that day. Okay, 25 May, I do a full-on shopping spree, and I did a whole vlog about that. So I won't go through everything that happened that day. June, I go back to Fendi again, and so I did a part two video of that as well.
Fendi for me, Fendi for you, I'll have a Fendi, you have one too. Fendi for me, Fendi for you,
I want to get off.
You can't get off, we have five more continents to visit.
21 June, I make my first ever purchase at Hermes, so it's just these four perfumes and it started to grow on me. 5 July, I pick up this pair of shoes and another glass of Moe, as you do. I also try on a whole bunch of ready-to-wear. I'll reverse the photo so it actually looks correct, but I was taking selfies in the mirror. I like that jumper, but honestly, it kind of makes me look like an employee there, wearing that jumper. So 8 July, I get a text from ISA at LV saying he's got an early birthday gift for me. Again, I did a vlog and unboxing of the pieces I got that day. 10 July, I wake up super early just to get to the Opera House to do this photo shoot and film some shots of the Opera House itself. Because I really didn't want to do it when there were a lot of crowds. So, what time? So I was there at around 7 a.m. So just capturing the morning sun as it rises and creates a nice warm glow. Might seem ridiculous to some, but framing your shopping bags is actually a good alternative for some wall art for your home. Top one was the shopping bag for Christmas 2022. The one under it was Paula Ibiza capsule collection in 2022. And this floral one was this year's Paula Ibiza collection. So yeah, I go to Fendi, just casually trying on a $10,000 bag, and then I bought some stuff. Not that bag. Here we go, my birthday photo. This is the same tuxedo that I wore for that family gathering event, but this time I'm wearing the Loewe bag charm as a bolo tie of sorts. So this is my haul for from 2023. So far, yeah, that was a lot of bags. The only two bags that were pre-loved was that Saint Laurent Sac de Jour and that Fendi soft trunk, but everything else is new. After I took that photo, I realized I had a lot of bags in a short space of time, so I really made a conscious effort to pace myself, and that's why in August, nothing happened. Like, literally, there's no photos in August. However, come 9 September, I go with someone else to the Fendi store and, well, I see this bag charm just hanging on another bag and I'm like, can I see that? And it took me all of 1 minute to decide that it was coming home with me that day. Okay, so 14 September, I pick up my gift from Loewe, which was for the Mid-Autumn Festival, which was these donut biscuits from the Flower Melbourne. I would like to go back to Melbourne just to go try that bakery for myself. There's also the Gomoku board game and this carry case made of pine. So I also decided to take a photo of my bag charm against and compare it against two other peekaboos, which are not mine, unfortunately. Here's a size comparison with my dog. 22 September, I had my eyes on this pouch that I really wanted, but it was taking forever to save money to afford it. But finally I was able to. Naturally, I take more selfies, more photos, more video. So I borrowed this other bag charm and got all of my miniature boxes and perfume samples and just did this photo shoot of sorts with the Wee Bear Bears. I go to the Art Gallery of New South Wales and do a photo shoot with the pouch. Gucci. Period. 27 September, I get a text from my SA saying that he has some mooncakes for me for the Middle Autumn Festival. Lava chocolate and black sesame. So these were actually made locally by this cake shop called Sweet Lou. And earlier this week, I actually finally had a chance to go to that dessert shop. Overall it was nice. A little bit pricey, but it was worth going. 2 October, I pick up some Dior Beauty items. Which, by the way, this hand cream slash body lotion, it smells good, but it's not really good for sensitive skin. It was a drastic change in weather, so that kind of made my skin dry. So I thought using this lotion would actually help, but it actually stung. I don't use this body lotion to actually treat my dry skin. I just use it as a hand moisturizer and that's it. 5 October, Louis Vuitton. Yeah, that was at David Jones Sydney. I was tempted to actually buy one of these, but I'd rather save my money for the real thing. 14 October, I go to the Hunter Valley. I'm kind of lying in this video. One glass worth was poured out for someone else, and then I drank the rest of this bottle. After I drank that, I was feeling a bit tipsy, but I still needed to take a whole bunch of photos before the sun went down. 21 October. What you are seeing now is footage, which I'm probably going to have to redact because there's a lot of faces that I need to cut out, of my reconnaissance trip to Cassette. If you're not familiar with the drama around Cassette, this retailer who stocks luxury brands like Valentino, Balenciaga, Bottega Veneta, they have been accused of selling counterfeit items. And I'll put links in the description to some of the news reports about it. But I decided to actually go into the store on this day and just check it out for myself. I was holding my phone in such a way to look discreet. So that's why the camera's just shaking all over the place. But I'm talking to one of the SAs there. She shows me this Balenciaga bag. And obviously I couldn't inspect every single piece to see if it was real or not. I don't own pieces from these brands to know enough if they are the real deal or not. What I will say is that the Bottegas were looking a little bit dry. And this Balenciaga bag that the SA had showed me, there was this fold along one side of it, and that same fold was on all of those bags, which I thought was a bit weird. But later on when I go to David Jones that has a Balenciaga stand there, I see the same bag on display and that one did not have the fold on it. I didn't really ask the SA any probing questions. I was just winging it at the time, so that was fun. 25 October. This scares me. At the time I had no idea what the heck this was. This giant animatronic head at David Jones Sydney just staring at me. So later on I actually found out what it was, so I'll put a screenshot of what this whole thing was about. 9 November. Yeah, I saw this bag on my Facebook feed and I immediately thought of this image. This bag really looks too lopsided. It's giving like Dior Saddle Kelly disorder. Okay, 22 October, I finally decide to put that Bottega bag that I bought from Vestiaire back onto Vestiaire. As of the filming of this video, that listing is still up. If you're interested in buying it, please buy it. 18 November, this is me posing with my puzzle bag. Santa had left for the North Pole that evening, so I kind of snuck into Santa's chair. In my defense, there were no security guards and everyone else was doing it, so I won't say which Westfield this was because I don't want to get anyone in trouble. 22 November, I pick up something from Loewe, which was this pop-up card, some swing tags, and this box of gingerbread biscuits. I've already tried one. Honestly, the gingerbread is not very strong, but this artwork is everything. And I also downloaded a whole bunch of wallpapers. I'll put a link in the description to a Dropbox link where you can download a whole bunch of these wallpapers So I have a few from Loewe and some from Rimowa for some reason. 26 November, I am at Dior again. I'm just doing some light shopping. Again, only there for the packaging. Of course, I have to buy something. So that's what I'm wearing right now. This Dior belt buckle. Just the buckle, not the belt. Dior thinks they're so clever that they would sell the buckle and belt separately and make you think that you need to buy both together. That's like $1,200. But this buckle actually fits on all of my existing belts. The belt I'm wearing right now is from LV. It's the 35mm size and it fits perfectly, as well as on my Loewe reversible belt. And my Fendi one. Like, this buckle works on all of them. So if you're looking to save some money but you still want the logo, just buy one leather belt strap and then you can buy your buckle from any brand you want. And I also filmed a lot of stuff there. Pro tip, if you want to get away with filming, make sure you go with a wingman to distract the SA, and while no one's looking, just quickly film as much as you can. Later that day, I go to Sweet Lou, which was that bakery that made the mooncakes for Fendi. 1 December, which was yesterday, they officially launched their Christmas collection with, I'm gonna butcher the name, but Loewe went all out with the bags and the accessories and the ready-to-wear. I didn't buy anything that day either. I just came for the free hot chocolate and cookie. And that's it. Okay. So I don't know if the rest of this year is going to be any more eventful. I'm hoping to pick up at least one more bag. And as you can see, this carousel has just been spinning non-stop. So consider this a long haul review of the efficiency of this carousel. I know I haven't been actively uploading. I don't commit to a schedule. I only upload if I have something worth sharing. If you're curious as to what I'm doing in between uploads, then follow me on Instagram because that's where all of these photos and videos are being shared in real time. So that is it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you so much to all of my subscribers. I'd rather have quality over quantity. So if you've stuck around for this long, thank you. In case I don't upload anything for the rest of this year, then Merry Christmas and have a Happy New Year. Bye for now.